Thank you so very much for being here today. What an awesome opportunity just to talk about the partnerships that Hillsborough County Public Schools has with every one of the individuals behind me this morning. You know, in my time as superintendent in Hillsborough County, I have focused on not only elevating the educational experiences for our students inside the classrooms, but also focusing on strengthening the career and technical educational pathways. And over the last 2 years, Hillsborough County has led the career technical educational pathways for the state for not only the courses taken by students, but courses passed by students throughout the state of Florida. And this is a recognition of our hard work of our teachers and our staff and our leaders, and we thank them for that process. But we're here today to talk about this great partnership that we have with Future Career Academy and all of the partners behind me that stand with us to be able to create a better tomorrow for our students. As you know, next year we'll be launching two new academies within our school district, one that is focusing on expanding the construction academy mindset for our students, but also being able to focus on healthcare as well as we expand a 9 through 12 medical academy in Hillsborough County. You see around me is champions for change, champions that stand to be able to create the best partnerships for our students and the greatest exposure as we create a talent pipeline for our students as they transition from pre-K to 12th grade in Hillsborough County and transition to the workforce. I'd like to do some brief introductions that we have here this morning. We have representatives from our governmental agencies, from state, constitutional offices, and also municipalities. We have business groups from many of our chambers, from our EDCs, and also from our trade associations. We have training partners for post-secondary education, like apprenticeship programs, HCC, Hillsborough Technical Colleges, and Career Source to be able to show up to help us in the Tampa Bay region. And we also have social service organizations like Feed in Tampa Bay, Safe and Sound, Spring CDC of Tampa, also with Tampa Family Health, and many other agencies, and also our employees that stand with us to be able to create this space. Our district is one of the largest pipelines of talent in this nation, as we are the seventh largest school district in the nation, serving 15,000 seniors every single year that transition from our school district to post-secondary education, to military, and also to the workforce. And we are deeply committed to providing meaningful preparation in connection to our students for in-demand, livable wages, entry jobs that learn out to be career growth and sustainability related to employment. Future Career Academies has been that instrumental constant approach that has helped us to create that exposure, to help us to have that incredible connections with the workforce and our partnerships. FCA has always had our students back, always showing them the next level steps to allow them to stay in the Tampa region and create and to have sustainability through a livable wage, and to join and to offer and to have a better understanding of what we create with the jobs within this geographical location for future employment. Our students have already begun this process. They've been actively engaged in businesses, engaged with civic leaders, community leaders, to learn about our agencies or corporations or companies and what they offer to our students. FCA has grown to be able to expose 9,000 students to job opportunities in corporations within the Tampa region this year. And in the months of January through February, 1,700 students have visited over 150 businesses representing 14 different industry sectors. And I want to be able to say that now we stand before you as a collective collaboration, and this is a call for action. Over the next coming months, we will hold 6 future fairs events for all of our graduating seniors, 15,000 of our seniors. And these will take place for job fairs in April. And we want every one of our students to be able to help you fill the talent pipeline, to help you fill roles and responsibilities within your corporations to create a better Tampa. In this process, not that will take place in April, but also in May, we will hold a signing day where students will select and be highlighted for the pathway that they have chosen and for the organization and the company that they will transition to as they sign to be able to go into a job or a training program that will strengthen who they are personally and professionally. But today I ask you to stand with us, to stand with this Tampa Bay region, to stand with the Future Career Academy and every one of our partners to help us create the best pathways for our students. For those companies and corporations who are trying to win the talent war, please connect with the Tampa Bay in the Tampa Bay region, connect with a future career academy, or also hit and highlight one of our QR codes that you see around the room today to let us know that you want to be an instrumental part of this process. I cannot thank enough Yvonne Fry for leading this initiative and creating opportunities for our students. She has truly been a champion to bring partners, organization, community leaders, civic leaders together in an effort to be able to close the workforce gaps that we experience every single day. But in education, we understand that we cannot do this in isolation, that it takes everyone to be able to work in a collective and a collaborative manner. It is my pleasure to introduce one of the greatest champions we have in the Tampa Bay region. This individual continues to double down in education and continues to find proactive solutions, resources, language, funding for our school district, and that is the Congresswoman, Mrs. Kathy Castor.
Well, good morning, everyone. Thank you for the opportunity to be here. And Superintendent Davis, I stand with you. I share the commitment of everyone here that we want to prepare our students for successful careers. I'm grateful to the Hillsborough County Public Schools, you, Superintendent Davis, our school board members, the Future Career Academies, the Board of County Commissioners, who's come in big for our students and employers. But I'm particularly grateful for the businesses, the unions, the governmental agencies who are standing here today providing those career pathways for our students. Right now, across America, there are 11 million job openings. The unemployment rate nationally is 3.4%. That is the lowest unemployment rate in 50 years. The unemployment rate has not been this low since 1969. That's well before many of the folks here were even born. There are enormous opportunities across the Tampa Bay area in healthcare, in manufacturing, in business, in hospitality, and more. Many of these opportunities do not require a four-year college degree. That's the beauty of the Future Career Academies and what's happening here in Hillsborough County. They are doing the hard work recruiting the employers, talking to them about the students who are ready, willing, and able to go to work. There is not a meeting in my office where I do not hear from a business or another agency that is hungry. They're hungry for talent, young talent, and that talent resides here in Hillsborough County Public Schools. We're so committed to this effort of career and technical education here in Hillsborough County that the Hillsborough County Public Schools has just won a $1 million community funding federal grant that will come it will help with the Building Tomorrow's Workforce Development Initiative for grades 9 through 12. This is what the superintendent was talking about the evolution, the repurposing, the next step in our career academies. This $1 million federal grant will help boost the Bowers Whitley, what's a career center now, turns it into an academy, a training academy. It will help especially with the building construction trades and training there. It will provide the instructional materials and a lot of the equipment that the school district needs to prepare our students. And it will also give the D.W. Waters Medical Academy a shot in the arm as that academy recruits students and targets opening for the fall of next year. And the Future Career Academy is complementary because it will work to open doors not previously open to our students. So I'm all in, Superintendent Davis, and to all the businesses and the employers here today. The future is bright here in Hillsborough County when we all work together. So thank you all very much.
Good morning. I'm County Commissioner Gwen Myers, representing District 3 and serving as Vice Chair on the Hillsborough County Board of County Commissioners. It is truly an honor to be here today. Hillsborough County recognized the importance and the success of the Future Academy and is proud to be a partner with FCA for a brighter future for our students and the business community. Through the business panel, field trips, and 6 future fairs, seniors in all of Hillsborough County High Schools have had the opportunity to meet and connect with business community to establish meaningful connections that can lead them to a well-paying career after graduation. We all know that all of our seniors, once graduated, they cannot afford to go off to college. And so, Yvonne, thank you for putting this program together, because we must provide opportunities for all of our students, because we know education is vital to the city, the county, state, and country. And we must look out for our future leaders. And so a great example of how this is working over a 4-week period from January to February, FCA has had 8 days of field trips where 1,763 students in 50 buses have visited a combination of 150 businesses close to their school and home. That's a lot of opportunities for jobs for our young people. But we have to thank FCA. In April, they will hold 6 future fairs events where students will be able to apply for jobs with businesses that they have already made contact with. This is a huge win-win for our seniors. Let me repeat, this is a huge win-win for our seniors who will be entering the workforce after graduation. It is a huge win-win for our business partners where they have community positions and say, you can stay home and work, take care of yourself, and help your family as well. So the future is bright for our seniors, and we thank the Future Career Academy for this opportunity, and thank you all.
Morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Nate Kills, and I'm the mayor of the wonderful city of Plant City, where it's always a great day, and where the Future Career Academy was conceived back in 2015. That's something that we're very proud of. And again, I want to thank Yvonne Fry and all the great business leaders there that came up with this idea. Even in 2015, there was a significant labor shortage in our entire region. It's been mentioned today how much more exacerbated that is in this day and age. And of course, the need to connect businesses with eligible graduating seniors was obvious. And we have a great success story with us today. Steve Hurley, owner of Stingray Chevrolet, if you'd raise your hand. He was one of our great business leaders in Plant City and committed to the program early on, and hired Chuck Santelli back in 2016. And Chuck has been promoted many times over because he's got great work ethic and he's a great young man. But that started a long, long time ago. And we continue to see that time and time again as we've gone through this process. So it fills my heart to see that this program is being extended all the way throughout Hillsborough County. And the city of Plant City is all in on this organization. I want to tell you a little bit about how we've been involved over time. We have several of our folks that have been involved in the business panels. We're committed to tables at the upcoming career hiring events. I think, but the most fun for us are the field trips. And just to give you a little bit of color on that, we put students on the tour buses and take them around to several of the businesses so they have an opportunity to get a feel for what's available in their backyard. And at the middle of the day, we stop at Plant City Stadium and we do a big parade for them where we bring out all of our department heads and employees from the different departments and then show them the different toys, the vehicles and things that they can work with. Our city manager went so far as to get into a bucket truck this year and was shooting t-shirts into the crowd with an air gun. So if you've ever been to a Lightning game and see how crazy people go over free t-shirts, that gives you a little bit of an idea. But it was a whimsical way to get the attention of these young people and then to introduce them to different opportunities in our city. So we had some of our younger employees not too far removed from high school come out and explain a little bit about how they got involved, how they could be hired without having much experience or background, and then get on-the-job training, and then have a very clear path forward in how they could excel in the organization. And another anecdote that I'll share with you, one of our other commissioners was on one of these buses, and they had just stopped at a business and learned a little bit about that business. They got back on the bus, and he was addressing them as they were going to the next stop, and he was a little perturbed that they were on their devices, but you know, having three teenage children myself, I know what it's like to fight for their undivided attention. But come to find out, what they were doing is they were applying for jobs at the place that they had just left. So we see time and time again that this process is working. And it's not just about, you know, connecting the students with the businesses. It's also about building these students up and making sure that they're ready for their next path forward. So the Future Career Academy is also instrumental in making sure that these young people have good communication skills, can build a resume, know how to dress for an interview, and you know, so that they can get their foot in the door and take the next step forward. I think it's also important about changing the narrative too, because when I was growing up, it was emphasized college, college, college. But a lot of the smartest and most successful people I know haven't gone to college. And we know that a lot of our students aren't going that direction. So to have an opportunity to give them a path forward, whatever they choose to do, and connect them and make sure that they know that there's opportunities in their backyard is invaluable. So I'm really thrilled for what's going on. So the charge to action today, I think, for those that aren't involved, especially in the business community, is to sign up for these career fairs, because you will get qualified, talented young people for your organizations, and then you can also help build the curriculum that are going to build these kids up for future success. So thank you very much.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Nadia Combs. I'm the chair of the Hillsborough County School Board, and it's just such an honor to be here today, standing in front of all these wonderful people who support education. Our biggest asset in this country and in this district is our students. They are the future. And we are seeing that only 30% of students, when they graduate from college, actually go to college and complete college. So we have 70% of our students who, at the end of their senior year, really are lost and don't know what the next step is. And what Future Career Academy does, it gives students hope. I've had the honor to serve on a business panel. I had the honor to go on field trips. And what I see over and over when those students are on the bus, I see hope for them. I see that they think, hey, I'm not going to go to UF. I'm not going to go to Florida State. What am I going to do with my life? And now they have a pathway for a future. And I think that's really, really important to see that many students can have a very successful future, can have a very successful life, because at the end of the day, it's creating skills and opportunities and making sure that our jobs also have those individuals there. Now more than ever, we're looking at a workforce where there's a shortage of people, where companies are looking for young people that they can mold and that they can adapt and that they can lead their businesses. So now what we have is we have a pathway. We have a pathway for our students to actually experience this, get those soft skills that we talk about, you know, in class, learning how to look at someone in the eye, creating a resume, going out, interviewing, getting a job. And so I want to thank Future Career Academy and everybody who's involved in technical and vocational programs, because we know that's the path for 70% of our students. If we can give students opportunities for jobs and opportunities to do well, then they're going to be successful and our economy is going to continue to thrive. So I want to thank everyone here who believes in that and supports that. And I really am asking for a call of action for people who have companies, who own businesses, who are looking for someone to work with them, who are looking for an employee. We have wonderful students here and we're going to provide the best opportunities for them to make sure that they have a successful future. So thank you to Von Fry, to Future Career Academy, for Superintendent Davis, our board, and all these individuals, our city, our state, our council, who are supporting this, because in the end, our biggest asset is our students, and we're finally putting this as a priority. Thank you.
Once again, look at the power in this room. Look at the knowledge. Look at the care for the Tampa Bay region. And we're doing this together. And I'm so thankful for this partnerships, but the call to action is real. We need every one of our Tampa region employers, organizations who are looking for young talent, who are looking to be able to create spaces for our students to come and thrive within your organization, to take us up on this call and join the Future Career Academy Workforce Fairs, and let's have an awesome signing day in May. At this time, we will close this out. We appreciate it. If there's any questions, this team's ready to answer. All right, thank you.